See, we all have our coping mechanisms, and this is mine. When I put a pad to a pen, everything just seems right. Let me tell you a story of what happened this time. Another close family member gone. Oh my. I was driving to work when I got the news, cruising round and blasting tunes. Then my bro phoned me and told me the news. My body froze up and I didn't know what to do. I raced back home, picked up my bro and headed back to the house. We came through the door but my dad had heard the news. We held on to him and cried out all our tears. Khala, you were so young and so dear. Because my mum flew out a few days ago to go see her beloved sister. And I'm so glad we booked the tickets, cause imagine if she missed her. Because getting to Yemen ain't no joke in these circumstances. But imagine if she never got closure, it would've seemed more disastrous. I still can't fathom the thought that this is true. Every time I face death, it always feels new. But yeah, you had to go back to your Lord. But yeah, I'm sitting here feeling so distraught. Cause she was so young, only 46 years old. Her husband now with 4 kids, and I don't even know anymore. Because the pain is running in so deep, like I feel I can't even speak. Ya Rab, let me just wake up from this bad dream. But I know Allah won't put you in a position that you can't handle. But the truth is, right now I'm startled. Startled with the fact I only saw you last July. Yeah, we were having the time of our life, chilling in Malaysia, but I didn't realize that this would be our last time. I didn't even feel to vlog those days. I just wanted a private family holiday, cause I came out there to surprise you. Mission accomplished. Now I'm locked up in these thoughts and moments, solitude fortress. Like the smile and happiness I saw on your face that day when you shrieked and hugged me. Yeah, that smile on your face. Who knew that would be one of the final days? And now it rips me up just thinking about it, flicking through the pics like, how has this really happened? Cause I had a 24-hour layover in Singapore on the way back, and you messaged me to check on me if I woke up and got my flight, just in case I didn't oversleep that night. Hello, Othman, sahi? Yes, now insert thumbs up emoji. Bakhrak fi sa'a, tawsal bi salama, inshallah. I guess I now hope to see you in Jannah. Ma salama.